I call, for you will surely heed me, O God. Turn your ear to me, hear my words. Guard me as the apple of your eye. In the shadow of your wings, protect me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you and with your spirit. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. May your grace not forsake us, O Lord, we pray, but make us dedicated to your holy service, and at all times obtain for us your help. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. Azariah stood up in the fire and prayed aloud, "For your name's sake, O Lord, do not deliver us up forever, or make void your covenant. Do not take away your mercy from us, for the sake of Abraham your beloved, Isaac your servant, and Israel your holy one, to whom you promised to multiply their offspring like the stars of heaven, or the sand on the shore of the sea. For we are reduced, O Lord, beyond any other nation, brought low everywhere in the world this day because of our sins. We have in our day no prince, prophet, or leader, no burnt offering, sacrifice, oblation, or incense, no place to offer first fruits to find favor with you. But with contrite heart and humble spirit, let us be received, as though it were burnt offerings of rams and bullocks, or thousands of fat lambs. So let our sacrifice be in your presence today, as we follow you unreservedly. For those who trust in you cannot be put to shame. And now we follow you with our whole heart. We fear you and we pray to you. Let us not be put to shame, but deal with us in your kindness and great mercy. Deliver us by your wonders and bring glory to your name, O Lord." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Remember that your compassion, O Lord, and your kindness are from of old. In your kindness, remember me because of your goodness, O Lord. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord, thus he shows sinners the way. He gives the humble to justice, he teaches the humble his way. Remember your mercies, O Lord. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Peter approached Jesus and asked him, "Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive him? As many as 7 times. Jesus answered, "I say to you, not 7 times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, 'Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full.' Moved with compassion, the master of the servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When the servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, "Pay back what you owe." Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, "Be patient with me and I will pay you back." But he refused. Instead, he had him put in prison until he had paid back the debt. Now when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to the master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, "You wicked servant, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant, as I had pity on you?" Then in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you, unless each of you forgives your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I'm sure if you're joining me for Mass today, you realize how surreal this is right now. As I look around this chapel, which is usually so filled with people, and I just see it, that I'm preaching to an empty crowd, and for the first time in front of a camera like this, how surreal it is that the world is in this state right now at this point, that it would come to this. The church, how seriously we take the Mass and how much we love the Eucharist, that we're in a situation where we're having to restrict the number of people who can even come to Mass for the sake of the common good. And that, brothers and sisters, to me, is just, it's one of the most strange and surreal things that I can imagine. And yet, at the same time, I find a lot of comfort in today's first reading. It's from, again, the book of Daniel. And Daniel was in a time when the temple had been destroyed. And the Jewish temple is where they would offer sacrifices on behalf of their sins. And so when that was taken away from them, the people of Israel had nowhere to go. They didn't know what they were supposed to do. The entire center of their spiritual life had been taken away from them. And so we hear the words of Daniel. It says, "We have in our day no prince. Their king had been deposed. He was gone. No prophet to tell them the word of God. No leader. No burnt offering, sacrifice, oblation, or incense. The things of the temple were taken away from them." And so his question is what are we supposed to do in this situation? And you know, brothers and sisters, actually, the church has this thing that I want to present to you in the absence of being able to receive communion. And it's the church's answer to the question, what are we supposed to do when we as Catholics can't celebrate the Mass? But I want to tell you that I take personally great comfort in knowing that the church has an answer to this question. Because if the church hasn't answered this question, that means that the church has been through this before, and it has gotten through it. The answer is a spiritual communion. And a spiritual communion is something that the church asks people to do when the church is in a state of persecution, and people can't leave their houses because they might be caught by the authorities. A spiritual communion is something that might have happened to the Christians throughout the world are experiencing today, where their priest was taken away from them, and they're not able to celebrate the Mass. A spiritual communion is something that we often tell the sick to do when they are no longer able to attend Mass because they are homebound and they're not able to receive our Lord. And yes, a spiritual communion is something that the Lord asks us to do when we no longer have the ability to celebrate Mass because of some sort of pestilence or plague. I was thinking about this, and I was praying about this last night. When the Spanish flu came through the United States in 1918, my grandfather was 8 years old. He lived through it. And so I am being able to join myself with so many Catholics throughout the ages, so many Christians, so many people who have been through this same thing. And yet they survived, they became stronger in their faith because of it. A spiritual communion, brothers and sisters, is just simply a simple prayer that the church offers us in the absence of communion. And it just goes something along these lines. Lord, I know that in this moment I can't receive you in Holy Communion, but I ask you to present yourself to me as if I am receiving you in communion right now. And what we believe as Catholics is that if we are unable to receive a communion because of serious circumstances, or if simply during the course of the day we feel like we need our Lord's presence, that he will come to us without delay and give us the same graces with the same, if we have a fervent heart when we do it, he'll give us the same graces when we receive communion, because our Lord never wishes to deny those who come to him. And then the beautiful thing is that when we finally are able to receive the Eucharist once again, when this church is once again filled, we will be able to receive our Lord for the first time. It will be like being with our Lord after having been only able to talk with him on the phone for a long period of time, to finally be able to be back with him and to see him face to face. And so after I receive my communion today, after I celebrate the sacrifice of the Mass, I want to be able to leave all of you in a prayer of spiritual communion, so that in this time when it seems like our Lord is so far away from us, we will realize that our Lord was never closer to us than he is right now. With confidence in our Lord's love for us, we present him with our petitions. We pray for our Holy Father and all of the bishops throughout the Church. We pray that in this time they may find ways of bringing the faith to their people, even as we are in our homes. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all those holding public office. We pray that those who are in charge of the care of our people find different ways of easing the burdens that we are experiencing. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the people of our parish. We pray especially for those who are homebound. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all doctors, especially the doctors of St. Peter Parish, who are so busily working in the hospitals right now. We pray that in those brief moments of silence that they may have a communion with our Lord. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the poor, the sick, and the dying. We pray in a special way for those who will die this day. May our Lord be their constant help and companion. We pray to you. Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we offer you these, our prayers and petitions. We ask you to hear and answer them if they be in accord with your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that this saving sacrifice may cleanse us of our faults and become an oblation pleasing to your almighty power. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your days. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be. Lord, who may abide in your tent and dwell on your holy mountain, whoever walks without fault and does what is just. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May the holy partaking of this mystery give us life, O Lord, we pray, and grant us both pardon and protection. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Bow your head and pray for God's blessing. O God, founder and ruler of your people, drive away the sins that assail them, that they may always be pleasing to you and ever safe under your protection. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.